Hello all, my name is Krishnak and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we'll be discussing about Euclidean and Manhattan distance. Now you may have probably heard about Euclidean and Manhattan distance in some of the algorithms like k-nearest neighbor and in some of the unsupervised algorithms like hierarchical mean clustering and k-means clustering. So understand guys, if we have two points like p1 and p2 and let us consider any dimension points, okay? So if I want to find out the distance between P1 and P2, I'll basically be using this particular parameters. And why do we find out the distance? Is to basically check that if this particular P1 and P2 are nearer to each other, then I will consider that these two points may be similar. So let us just go and discuss what exactly is Euclidean distance and Manhattan distance. So let me just show you a good example over here. So let me consider that I have one point over here and the other point over here. This point is basically represented by x1 comma y1. This point is basically represented as x2 comma y2. Now understand guys, I've just drawn a two-dimensional graph, right? So this may be my x value, this may be my y value. Now, in order to find the distance between them, right? I will first of all show you how Euclidean distance is basically calculated. Euclidean distance is basically calculated based on the Pythagoras theorem. Let me consider that. I have three points A, B, C. Now, based on the Pythagoras theorem, what we have the formula? AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square, right? So, this is the simple Pythagoras theorem. In short, what I can write, AC is equal to root of, this is basically square root of AB square plus BC square, right? Now, let us try to replace this AB square and BC square and see how the formula will look like. Now, I want to calculate this AB value. Now you know that this AB value, if I just try to project it towards the x-axis, this value will become my x1 and this value will become my x2, right? So the AB value can be calculated by subtracting x2 with x1, right? So I can basically write this as x2 minus x1 whole square plus, now what about BC square, this particular value? Let me just project this in my y-axis. So when I project this into my y-axis, this is basically my y1 and this is basically my y2. Now if I want to calculate the distance, I can just write y2 minus y1 whole square. And that is the most simplest formula of a Euclidean distance. Okay, so here we are basically taking this hypotenuse value, which I'm representing as D. In short, I can represent this as AC. I'm basically calculating with the help of Euclidean distance. So this is what a Euclidean distance exactly is, the formula is. Okay, now, suppose this A and C points, okay, suppose I have these two points. Now this is in the case of two dimension. In the case of three dimension, what will happen? This point will be represented as x1, y1, z1. And this point will be represented as x2, y2, z2. Now how the formula will work in this case is that I will add one more term over here and it will become z2 minus z1 whole square. And this same formula will apply for any number of dimensions. We'll just be increasing the additional dimension which is basically added over here. And finally, we will be getting the D value, that is my hypotenuse value. And this complete formula is basically called as Euclidean distance. This is how a Euclidean distance is basically computed. Pretty much simple. Now, the next question is that what is Manhattan distance? I hope you understood this. Okay, so let us go and understand what exactly is Manhattan distance. So I'm just going to rub this again quickly. Now, what I'll do is that I will take a simple plane again. Okay, I have my one point over here, the other point over here. Now, here also I have x1, y1. Here, it is basically represented by x2, y2. So, this is my x, this is my y. Now, I want to find out the distance between this. So, I'll just draw the same hypotenuse. Okay. Now, remember, in the case of Manhattan distance, if this is my A, C and B. Okay. Now in case of Manhattan distance, directly we do not compute the hypotenuse. Instead, we will calculate this distance plus this distance. Right. Now how to calculate it? Again, I'll project this over here. This is my x1. This is my x2. Right. Because this particular point x2 and y2 is here. So if I project it down over here towards the x-axis, this becomes my x2. This becomes my x1. Now similarly, if I project this over here for the y-axis, this will basically be my y2, this will basically be my y1. Now, according to Manhattan distance, the best way to calculate the formula is basically combining this and this. Okay, if I want to combine this and this, I will just say that this is nothing but x2 minus x1 absolute term. Absolute term basically means that whether this is positive or negative, it will always become positive. Then plus the absolute of y2 minus y1. And this is the basic formula to calculate the Manhattan distance. Simple. Okay. If I want to calculate this and this, I'm just basically adding this particular value and this particular value. And I'm making it as an absolute. If it comes as a negative, I'm just going to make it as positive. That is what I mean by absolute value. Okay. Now, this was pretty much about Euclidean and Manhattan distance. Now, the question rises, where do we use this and where do we use Euclidean distance? Let me give you a very good example for this. And why the name Manhattan also? I'll just tell you that. And that is how I remember. So, if you go in a developed country like US, right? There, you'll be seeing that the whole city will be planned in blockwise. Suppose like this. This will basically be the blockwise. So blockwise basically means that, just consider that all the homes, all the buildings are basically present in these boxes. These lines are basically the road, right? Now just imagine I want to go from this point, basically from this point of my road till here, right? So at that time, just imagine how the distance will get calculated. The distance will not get calculated like this. Instead, the distance will get calculated somewhere like this. Because the road over here, you can see these all are buildings, right? It cannot just cross the building directly. Instead, it will follow a pattern which is basically called as Manhattan distance by following the road pattern like this. Okay. Now, similarly, let me just give you another example where Euclidean distance can be used. I think you have seen, like, if you want to fly from one place to another place, right? Suppose I want to fly from, let me just consider that I want to fly from Bangalore to New York. Right now, if you see in the map, right, the flight A traffic will basically be pointing the distance from here to here. Suppose this is Bangalore. I'm just saying for an example, and this is New York, right? So I may consider this part directly and I may consider the hypotenuse part instead of calculating like this, right? So that particular distance parameter will be used in that particular scenario. So most of the Google Maps over there in most of the developed countries works in this particular pattern only. And by that also, you'll be able to get distance, how many kilometers, how much time it may reach over there, and all those kind of stuff. And this was the basic example and difference between Euclidean and Manhattan distance. And you also understood what is the main practical application over there, right? So this was all about this particular videos, guys. And in most of the machine learning use case also, we usually use both the cases and try to see which is working better. And we usually select it. Again, this is a kind of parameter. So you should always try with the help of cross validations, you know, which is the best parameter. You can basically use hyperparameter optimization so to see which whether Euclidean distance works well for that machine learning algorithm or Manhattan distance works well. So this is all about this video, guys. I hope you liked this particular video. Please make sure you subscribe the channel, share with all your friends. And one more very important thing that I wanted to say, I want to thank you all because my channel has basically reached 10K subscribers. Please keep supporting the channel. I'll bring more interesting content. Share with all your friends. Whoever requires this kind of help, I'll see you all in the next video. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.